Workspaces let us organize our team and our sites. In this lesson, we'll explain how to create a new workspace. We'll go over how to add seats and team members to your workspace. We'll talk about roles and permissions at the workspace level. And finally, we'll see how to manage your workspaces. A couple of notes here. Everyone begins with a starter workspace in Webflow, but you can upgrade to add enhanced staging capabilities and advanced collaboration features as needed. So there are some capability differences between workspace plans. Let's jump right in and create a new workspace. Here, when we click in, we can see our current workspaces. Yours might look different. In fact, you may only have the starter workspace that everyone gets by default. Or you might be part of someone else's workspace, like me. But to create, to add a new workspace, we go to Create Workspace. From here, you can name your workspace and then follow a workflow to pick the best plan depending on your needs. That's creating a new workspace. Let's talk about seats. Before we can add members, collaborators, in this workspace, we need to add seats, and we can add as many as we need. And you might be thinking, what the hell is a seat? Seats determine the number of teammates or collaborators that can work with you in Webflow. There are three types of seats. We have full, limited, and then there are free seats, but more on that later. The seat type determines which roles members can be assigned and the set of permissions that they'll have in Webflow, which we'll also talk about a little bit later. All workspaces come with one full seat for the workspace owner. Okay, now that we have some seats, we can invite teammates to fill the seats we just added and then assign them roles. Let's look at how to add and even remove team members from seats. From any of my workspaces, I'm here in this workspace, I'll go into the team settings. From here, since we're viewing this as the workspace owner, we see an overview of how many members we already have. And we can also invite new members to our workspace if we have any available seats. And as you invite new members, you can choose their role. You can also change this later. The role you assign each workspace member depends on what you want them to be able to do in the workspace or the sites within this workspace. That's adding members. Let's talk about how to manage them. As we mentioned earlier, we have three types of seats, and we'll start with full seats. Generally, full seats are needed for members who have more responsibilities within your team. The roles that can be assigned to members with a full seat are admins, who can manage workspace settings and billing, site managers, who can manage site settings and billing, and designers, who can access all of the site design features. Next, we have limited seats. The roles that can be assigned to members with a limited seat are marketer, who can build pages using building blocks like templates and components created by your designers, and they can also edit content, content editor, who can only edit site content, and third, the final seat type, are free seats for reviewers. Their purpose is mostly focused on giving feedback with comments or approving work if you're on an enterprise plan. And whatever role you assign a member at the workspace level, by default, they will be assigned this role at the site level. And if you're on a plan that has site-specific access, you can choose which sites to give them access to as you invite the new member. But on any individual site, we can go into the site access settings and add or remove members from the site, unless they're also an admin, and change the role. Okay, back in my workspace team settings, there's one more way to add collaborators to your workspace, and that's agency or freelancer guests. This is an option where you can have experts who have their own agency or freelancer workspace to join your workspace to help out with your work. And once they're in your workspace, you can assign them pretty much any role they'll need to support you. So, we know the seat type determines what kind of role each team member can have. Let's set up an example of what a real team structure could look like. You, the workspace owner, will need full access to everything in your workspace and your sites. So you'll need a full seat, and you'll get one for free to start. Your team has a web designer who needs to have a designer role in your sites. So they'll need a full seat in your workspace and be assigned the designer role. You have a growth marketer who will need to be able to build pages with designer-approved building blocks and do some content editing in sites, but not everything else. They'll need a limited seat and be assigned the marketer role. And lastly, you have a VP of marketing who will need to review sites and provide feedback. They can have a free seat and be assigned the reviewer role. So that's just one example of how a team structure can work. That's seats and roles. Let's move on to the final step. Up here in our account dropdown, we can access an overview of the workspaces we are a part of. We can see our role in each workspace, how big the team is, and how many sites there are in each workspace. And depending on your role, you'll have different options here. But also, if you don't need to be a part of a workspace anymore, you can always leave that workspace over here. Okay, let's recap. We created a new workspace. We added seats and members to a workspace. We went over the seats and roles. And finally, we showed where you can manage your workspaces. That's a high-level overview of how workspaces work in Webflow.